एक बार मेरे खुद के जूता खरीदने के लिए मैंने एक दुकान गया था। मेरे पैर ऐसा है ना, 8 नंबर को फंसता है ना 9 नंबर पे, बीच में है। तो इस बीच में मेरे पैर के लिए कोई उस दुकान में जूता नहीं है। तो मैंने जब दुकानदार को बताया कि आप मेरे पैर के साइज के जूता निकाल के दे दीजिए, तो उन्होंने कोशिश किया, फिर मिलने के मिला नहीं। जब उन्होंने कहा कि हम तो नंबरों के लिए जूता बनाते हैं, इंसानों के लिए जूता नहीं बनाते। फिर थोड़ी देर उनके साथ बहस करने के बाद उन्होंने कहा कि आपके पैर में कुछ गड़बड़ी है।
Are we here to discover, recover something that is there, obvious, it exists, but is got overlaid, obscured? Or are we here to create something new as learning society?
Okay. I feel that every time we get into any discussions, you know, at whatever level, in my own family or at the national level, as you say, that we're always obsessed with solutions. What is the solution, somebody says? And then again, one feels threatened. Why are we obsessed with finding solutions instead of being obsessed with asking questions about ourselves, asking questions about our relationships, asking questions about reality? And I think I personally would like to engage myself in this discourse in asking questions, and not being obsessed or not feeling guilty of not finding the right answers to set our own strategies or set agendas and things like that.
So really, this meeting, we've tried to set it up so we can really have a chance to dialogue and create dialogue in different kinds of ways. So we resisted creating log frame timetables, 1 o'clock to 1:15. Brush your teeth, 1:15 to 1:30, go to the bathroom, and so on and so forth. So it's very fluid, the whole, and there's a lot of space for all of you to design and to create the spaces which we want to have this dialogue in. That the starting point is not governments, it's not corporations, it's not international agencies. It's people and their everyday experiences, their natural learning processes, their wisdom, their creativities, and use that as the starting point for a different kind of dialogue, reflection, action, creation process.
There is an economic system that I see as inherently violent and not compassionate, and there's the short-term goal of having to, everybody needs to fulfill very basic needs and needs to link up to the system to fulfill those, yet at the same time every linkage strengthens the system, and we need to weaken the system, which I feel is a need. We need to be able to be independent of it and do other things and look at other alternatives. And how do we handle this dichotomy between an immediate goal and a longer term goal?
What can we do to ignite and foster and continue to pursue the creativity in individuals? Because I believe that for society to survive in the rest of the world, we all need to be creative.
मैं मानता हूं कि आज की एजुकेशन सिस्टम क्या कहती है स्टूडेंट्स से, जो कि बिल्कुल फ्री माइंड के हैं, जिन्हें फ्री रखना चाहिए उनको. तो मैं ये थोड़ा अंग्रेजी में पढ़ लेता हूं, 5-6 वाक्य मैंने अभी लिखे हैं. हे यू ऑल बटरफ्लाइज, कैरी स्कूल बैग्स ऑन योर बैक, डू नॉट फ्लाई फ्री लाइक दिस हियर एंड देयर. हे यू ब्यूटिफुल रिवर स्ट्रीम्स, डू नॉट फ्लो इन एन अनइवन मैनर, फ्लो स्ट्रेट, डू नॉट नॉइज, फ्लो पीसफुली. हे यू ऑल कलरफुल फ्लावर्स, wear same color uniform. Hey you all fishes, do not swim here and there unevenly, swim straight in a line like swimming championship.
Education system, it's like factory. It has become like a factory which gives you certain facts and figures and takes away everything that we call life. Basically, what life is, actually, instead of giving life to children, it is taken away from them in the process of learning, which is so sad. It numbs your feelings, it numbs your thoughts, everything.
So far, wherever I've been involved in institutions or in learning in a formal sense, has been that I'm asked to conform to a system of life or a way of life that basically isn't about living my life. It's about living someone else's life. It's about the state, or it's about education, or it's about something that's very abstract. And to have your life orientated towards your family or your culture or your values is very difficult today.